Hello everyone. Today we are talking about half halts and specifically how to correctly half halt from your seat and your thighs. I had someone write in a question about this and I thought it was a really good question because for one, half halts are kind of this mysterious thing that we don't really understand. And for two, a lot of riders do them incorrectly using the incorrect muscles. So I'm going to talk you through the half halt today. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe so that you get notified when I post a new video every week. Also, if you look in the description box, I have a free rider position mini course that will help you to get in the correct position and then make more effective half halts. So this is Jacques. And the first thing that I want you to think about is if you're riding along and you're going to make a half halt, what muscles are you going to use in your body to make a half halt? What most people do is that the first muscle they use is their arm or their bicep, and then they tend to kind of clamp with their butt, like their gluteus maximus, squeeze their butt, and maybe squeeze with their knees at the same time. The other thing you might be thinking about is your abs, like your six-pack abs. So actually, when you ride a half halt, those are not the muscles that you want to use. When I ride a half halt, the biggest muscle that I use is actually the glute med. So the glute med is a muscle that's more on the side of your leg as opposed to your glute max. Because if you squeeze your butt, it actually pushes you up out of the saddle, which you don't want. When you ride a half halt, you want to wrap yourself around the horse and sink deeper into the saddle. So the glute med is a muscle that allows you to do this. If you want to feel your glute med, you can take your foot out of the stirrup and kind of lift your leg away and put your leg back onto the horse a few times. So take your knee actually off of the saddle and then let it lay back into the horse. And you'll feel kind of like right here, that will activate when your leg comes away. So you want to use your glute med when you ride a half halt to really wrap your legs around the horse. And then yes, your abs, but it's more your obliques and your transverse abs, as well as your glute med that keeps you really stable in the saddle. Let me show you now how to apply this idea of a half halt. I also really think that it's important when you ride a half halt, that a half halt should be a gathering of energy so that you can do something with it. A half halt is not necessarily slowing down. So you ride a half halt like when you're going to make a transition to the trot from the walk, or when you're coming into the corner. It's like punctuation in a sentence. It's like a comma where there's a little pause and then something happens, but it's not necessarily taking energy away from your horse. So if I'm going to make a trot transition, I ride one little half halt. I kind of squeeze my glute med, wrap my leg around my horse, and then ask for the trot. So I think I pretty much only do one quick half halt for a walk trot transition. But then if I'm going to do a trot to walk transition, I'm going to go half halt, half halt, half halt, half halt, walk. Good boy. So a couple of things that you'll notice when I did that is that the half halts always are in tempo with the gait. A half halt is never just like pulling for five steps, or you never hold a half halt for more than one revolution of the gait. So what I mean by that is if I'm trotting here, right, and I want to get ready to make a transition to the walk, I'm gonna half halt now, 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 walk. And what it allows you to do when you half halt in rhythm with the gait is that it allows your half halts to actually be more effective. So the timing of your half halts is really, really important. If, for example, I'm trotting and all of a sudden I just tighten my glute med and tighten my abs, there's a disconnect between me and him. You saw how he kind of dropped his back and got slow, and I came a little bit out of the saddle. So that's why it's really important, the timing of your half halt, as well as using the correct muscles. And let me just demonstrate once to you what happens with a half halt if you use your biceps and your six-pack abs, because I think that's what a lot of us do, is that if I'm going along and all of a sudden I squeeze my glute mac, my six-pack abs, and my bicep, that's exactly what happens. So your six-pack abs are going to cause you to basically do a crunch, which you don't want to do in a half halt. You want to stay sitting tall like this and pooch your belly out. So six-pack abs cause you to do this. Squeezing your glute pushes you out of the saddle, and your biceps tip you forward. So you can see that that's really not the right muscle group for an effective half halt. Instead, what you want to do for an effective half halt is you want to really kind of drape your legs around the horse and then use more your side ab muscles to give intermittent half halts. So it's like half halt, walk. Good boy. And this horse is really good about listening to the half halts from my seat. Some horses aren't that good. So if I'm trying to ride a downward transition and I give, say I'm going along at the trot, and I give him a few like clear half halts from my core and my seat and nothing happens, then I'm gonna maybe give half halt with my rein. And I might stop and then even back him up a half a step so that there's a little bit of a consequence when he doesn't listen to my half halt. Then I'm gonna trot again, and then next time repeat that aid a little bit more subtle again. So there definitely is an art to, if your horse doesn't respond correctly to the half halt, you need to do more and make them listen to the half halt in the way that you want it. So like I said before, so much of what we do in dressage is we try to work towards subtle aids and getting our horse really responsive. So the half halt needs to be something that they respect. And if you're half halting, and they're not kind of gathering that energy or listening back to you, then you may need to do something a little more abrupt, like halt, rein back, and then go on again, so that the next time they have more respect for the half halt. The other thing that I want to mention is that half halts are very different on different horses. So on a lazy horse, your half halts are going to be a little bit softer and with more leg to keep them energized, as opposed to with a hot horse, your half halt might be more hand, like starting with your seat, but you might need to support more with your rein. One last thing that I want to talk about is half halts in the canter, because in the canter, it's super important the timing of your half halt. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So in the canter is a three-beat gait. So there's an up phase. Come on, buddy. There's an up phase, there's a level phase, and there's a down phase. The best way to start to feel this is to look at your horse's mane. And when the mane flies up, so it's up, 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 up. That's also when your hips swing forward in the saddle. And that's the moment that you want a half halt. So if I'm gonna ride a half halt at the canter, first I'm gonna get him in front of my leg. So your horse has to be in front of the leg so that you can ride a half halt. Like, you have to have energy to gather it. So if I'm gonna ride a half halt, it's gonna be now, 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 now. Now with him in the canter, he's not so strong behind. So my half halts can't be too strong, otherwise he's gonna break. If I wanna make a downward transition, I'm gonna go half halt, trot. Good boy. Let me show you once the other way. And let me show you what happens if you half halt at the wrong moment in the canter. So if you half halt on the downbeat of the canter instead of the upbeat of the canter, it's going to put your horse on the forehand. So if I half halt when the mane is down, 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 you see him lose his balance. So half halt, half halt, half halt, half halt. You see how he curls and almost breaks to the trot. So let me show you again. Down, 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 down. That's not good. You really want to half halt when the front feet are coming off the ground so that your horse gets more uphill. So I want to think up, 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 up. Good boy. So in addition to gathering up the energy, good boy, the half halt is really important for rebalancing your horse. And in dressage, we want to teach our horses to carry more weight on the hind end as opposed to on the front end. So that's where half halts, and particularly at the canter, the correct timing of the half halt is really important to get more energy and more engagement behind the saddle as opposed to putting him more on the forehand. So I hope this video helps you guys with your half halts. Let me know in the comments what helps you with your half halts, what your struggle is with your half halts. Like I said, every horse is different and every half halt is different. So you have to really be a feeling rider and have a sense of how hot is your horse? How lazy is your horse? Do they need more leg today? Do they need more rein today? And then, like I talked about, make sure that you're using the correct muscles in your body. It's not your bicep and it's not your six-pack abs. So you need to think about your glute med and also your transverse and oblique abs. I do have a full rider position masterclass where we work with a physical therapist, and she goes more into depth on this and also gives you specific exercises that you can do off of the horse to strengthen these muscles. Because what's hard about dressage is that you don't need the big muscles to ride well. You're not using like your quad and your six pack and your bicep. You're using the smaller stabilizing muscles to be an effective and good rider. So it's important that your fitness routine off of the horse caters to that. So that's it for today. Thank you, Jacques, for being our demo horse, and we'll see you in the next video.